comes to getting last-minute tickets to an upcoming game or concert, who can you trust? Ticket brokers make it easy, but prices vary, and scammers are always lurking out there. Here's Good Morning Indiana anchor Beth Vaughn.
The internet has made it simple to buy tickets to a sold-out show or ball game. But before you type in your credit card information, ask yourself these two simple questions. How much are you willing to pay? And will you get what you pay for?
Shopping for tickets online might seem easy, but comparing prices actually can be difficult. Because when you're looking at prices, you may not realize the final price till you go through the checkout funnel with added fees.
That's a common tactic for many virtual brokers. Brokers who don't stock tickets themselves. They resell someone else's tickets and make money through add-on fees.
Unfortunately, sometimes the sites are set up where they're hoping you get all the way to the end, you put all your information in, and you won't leave because you've done all that work.
Mike Peduto has been brokering tickets for 3 decades. He warns you to steer clear of any site that demands payment by wire transfer or avoid speaking directly to you. A good broker can offer insight on the venue and even offer a better deal as time dwindles.
I would say more often than not, the prices come down as you get closer. One thing I would say, if you only need 2 tickets, waiting till last minute, you can sometimes save some money.
Look for someone who's a member of the National Association of Ticket Brokers. And before you buy your tickets, Angie's List says you need to review the terms of sale or service. Beth Vaughn, RTV6.